Interlace fingers. Palms facing up, breathe in to bring the energy of the earth up towards your heart, inhale. And as you exhale, send your palms towards the ceiling as high as you can. Press the seat bones down and lift the ribs a bit higher. And the palms, push them up, send the shoulders behind the ears. And keep lengthening the arms up, inhale more. And slowly lower your hands to the floor. Breathe out at the same pace, belly comes in. Now, fingertips down, start to move your torso around. Slowly, to feel the lower back mainly. Then take one hand off the floor and draw some large circles above your head. The other hand is on the floor. Reach forward and out to the side. Then look up and follow your hands with your eyes, with your head. Make the circles as wide as you can. Breathe in when you feel really open, or breathe in to open fully. And breathe out when you come down. Then switch side. In both directions. Let's come into our Ujjayi breath as we start moving. Feel the whispering sensation in the throat. And let's create the whispering sound as well. Now, let's come back here. One hand at the back, one, the other hand outside. Let's do a gentle spinal twist, but really, really gentle. And we elongate upwards first, always, before twisting. Breathe out, belly comes in. Inhale, lift the heart a bit higher. Exhale, belly comes in. Breathing in. Breathing out through the nose. And switch side. Do that for 3, 4, 5 slow and gentle breath. Now let's do 3, 4, or 5 breath again on each side, but let's cross the legs in the opposite way, bring the other leg in front and go to the other side again. Maybe you come a bit deeper in the twist. Twist from the mid and upper back. Sending the back shoulder as far back as you can. Keep both shoulders down. Bring belly in all the way in and hold it in for a moment. As much in as you can. And go to the other side slowly. Inhale, lengthen up. Exhale to twist, suck the belly in behind the ribs. And release. Let's come in Balasana, child pose for a moment. Preferably with the knees wide open, creating space between the within the hip joints. Lengthening torso forward. The head down, the palms wide, shoulders relaxed. Ujjayi breath. Listen to your Ujjayi breath. Press your hands down and push the lower back a bit further back towards the heels. Lengthen the spine, breathe in along the spine. And slowly come up. Some free movement around the spine. I'm going to turn around to face the light, maybe. Is it better? I'm not sure. Maybe this way. I'm not too sure. Is it better like this? You see me better like this or like this? The other way? Not sure? Okay, I'll stay like this. Okay. Let's come into downward facing dog. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Lift the sit bones up. Push the heels down and keep your heels between your upper arms. Bend the legs a little, breathe in softly through the nose. To expand sideways. Exhale. Just find a bit more space between your ribs and bring the belly in. Bend the legs, let's step forward. Let's come into ragdoll for a moment. Bend the legs and lengthen yourself forward. Let the upper body fall forward. Tap the back of the thighs if it's as tight as mine. With the fist. Fingertips down, you lengthen yourself forward a little more. Inhale and forward. Now maybe you push the kneecaps back a little. Keep the head looking back. Neck relaxed. Come to a flat back, feet together, breathe in. And fold to exhale. Slowly come up. Not sure if you can see me all the way. So we stand at the front of the mat. Take both arms up, inhale. On the exhale, bring the hands to the floor. So I'm at the back of my mat, but you at the front. Long flat back, breathe in. Exhale to fold, then come into a plank. Let's hold the plank here for a moment. Curling the tailbone under and let the belly come up a little. Push the chest away from the mat. Spread all 10 fingers. Let's bring the knees down. Rotate the arms out to send shoulders away from the jaw. Move the chest forward. And as you exhale, you bring the chest down, squeeze elbows in towards the ribs. Then come down. Cobra, breathing in. Should feel comfortable, cobra pose. Curl the tailbone down, so there's a little back bend here. Although it's a gentle back bend, let's curl the tailbone down nonetheless. Open more space in the lower back. Lift the heart a little high, maybe elbows come off the floor a little. If you want to build upper body strength, bring the elbows up, lower shoulders, and squeeze armpits and elbows towards each other. Breathe in. It's good for the breast. And down slowly. Hands below the shoulders, downward facing dog. Take your time. Feel the body. Breathe in through the nose. Breathe out, push the heels down, send the hips back. Belly comes in. Again, inhaling, exhaling. Then the legs step forward. Come to a long flat back, inhale. Exhale to fold. Inhale, unfold. Sweep both arms up. Hands to your heart. We've done one round of sun salutation A. Let's come into chair pose to start one round of sun salutation B. Sit low and expand upwards, inhale. Come the tailbone down. Sit a bit lower. Spread all 10 fingers, inhale. Fold forward, exhale. Long flat back, chest bone moves forward, the belly comes down, tailbone up. Look forward, exhale forward. Press the hands down, step back into downward facing dog. One breath in through the nose. Breath out, slowly move forward into a plank. Breath in through the nose. Breath out, back to down dog. Straighten arms, feel your armpits becoming more spacious. Roll shoulders out slightly. Then take the right leg up. Inhale. Try not to open the hips, to rotate the hips right now. Both hips face down, the toes face down. You push through the heel, leg is straight. Yes, and straight leg, push through the heel. Breathe in, press the hands down. And step forward, warrior one. Solidly grounded, hips facing forward. Lengthen up, inhale. Press the outer edge of the back foot down. Make sure the back foot is not 90 degrees out, but 45 in. Inhale, bring the lower abdomen in, and let's lower the hips. Exhale softly through the nose. Let's do two more breaths here. If we can, let's bring the front thigh horizontal. Open to warrior two. Curl tailbone under slightly. Lengthen spine up, inhale. Bring the left arm across the back. Aware of the shoulder rolling back, so you can go far across your back. And take the right arm high, inhale through the right side. Exhale to reverse. Breath in, breath out. Both hands down. Vinyasa high plank. To a low plank, maybe with the knees down. Elbows in, chest down. Lengthen into cobra. Inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. One breath in. One breath out to push the hips back, tailbone up. Press both hands down. And take the left leg up, lengthen through the heel, to the back of the leg. Inhale, step forward, warrior one. Stay in your ujjayi breath. Three breaths, lower abdomen in, ribs moving up. Shoulders down, torso long. Warrior two. Bind the right arm across your back. Open the left side up, inhale. Reverse exhale. Relax neck, chin down. Press the front foot down. Both hands to the floor, Stepping back to a plank, high plank, low plank exhale. Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, upward facing dog. Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Take a breath in through the nose. Sigh out. Soften into the knees, step forward. Come to a long flat back at the front of the mat. Inhale, chest moves forward. Shoulder blades move back towards the center. Fold forward, exhale. Utkatasana, chair pose. Lengthen torso. Uttanasana, fold forward. Long flat back, inhale. Forward, fold, exhale. Let's come back to ragdoll. Take the feet wide. Bend the legs, fold forward. Breathe through your back. Shoulders loose, neck relaxed. Move the jaw from side to side, maybe. And then bring the feet together, cross the legs and sit down. Come on your back. Grab the knees and roll on your back a few times. It's coming to a supported bridge. One block or two blocks. Now, if you don't have blocks, buy some. But if right now you don't have blocks, you do a bridge unsupported. Actually, you can do a supported bridge without blocks. You bring your hands, you lift the hips, shoulders pressing down, you lift the hips. Let's do that, everyone. Let's take the blocks out. Let's be together with those who haven't invested in their practice yet in terms of props. Bring the elbows down close to the hips. Curl the tailbone up. Lift the hips high and bring the back of the hips here to rest into your palms. Move the elbows as close to each other as you can. And then bring the heels down, fingers on the side here. You rest on the palms. Press both feet flat. Breathe in, open your heart space. Close your eyes, relax the face, come back to your Ujjayi breath. Press the left foot down, take the right leg up. Leg straight. And switch side. Then bring both legs up, maybe. And then bring the feet down. Lift the tailbone up, inhale. Release your hands, bring the spine down slowly. Exhale. Let the spine come down all the way down. Bring the legs into butterfly pose. Let the thighs, the knees fall out to the side. Turn your hands to face up for a moment. Close, keep your eyes closed. Relax your face. Relax your solar plexus. Stay in your Ujjayi breath. Soften, lengthen the breath. You can sigh out. Rock the hips gently from side to side. Then bring the knees to the chest.
So after little moments connected down to the energy of the earth, energy comes down, we can go a bit fiery again for a moment. Start to rock on your back. Let's bring the energy up again. Move forward, cross the legs, pluck your hands down, and step or jump back into a plank, high to low plank. Inhale into cobra or upward facing dog. And downward facing dog. Breathe out.
Walk on the spot a few times slowly to reconnect with how you feel in your body, in the legs, in the lower back, through the sides, relax neck and face. And take the right leg up. This time bend the leg and open your right side. Take the knee as high as you can. Rotate the foot, rotate the lower leg, and start to rotate the thigh in and out, out to in. Then bring the knee to the chest. Exhale, move forward. Inhale, lengthen up. Bend and open. And come into Wild Thing. The hips go up, the chest bone moves up to face the ceiling. The spine is arching up. Breathe. Back to a three-legged dog. Bend the leg open and step forward. Step forward here. Lower the left knee a little. Interlace fingers in your back. Pull the shoulders back. Lift your heart up. Pull the hands away from your butt. Arms straight. Feel the shoulder blades moving back towards each other. Lift your heart more. Keep the chin down. Again. On the exhale, bring your hands together. Take a breath in. Let's bring the knee down. Left elbow outside of the right thigh. And come into a lunge twist. Relax neck. Roll your top shoulder back. Bring the belly in. Now curl the back, the toes under in the back foot, and take the kneecap off the floor. Stay in the twist. Now lower the armpit closer to the thigh. Lower the left hand towards the floor, or maybe on a block here on the side. Keep your arm connected to your knee and take your right hand up to the ceiling. Press the feet down, press your hand on the block and lift your right shoulder away from the jaw. Activate fingers. Take a deep breath in. Relax the cheeks and the jaw. Slowly come out. Bring the left knee down. Grab your blocks. If you have two blocks, you can press your hands on the block here. And let the hips sink. Press on the blocks to lift your heart up. Now send your left foot as far back as you can. Press the front foot flat. Breathe in. Lift the lower ribs a bit higher. Breathe out, let the hips sink deeper. Remove the blocks. Roll to bring the left hip down. So we're sitting now on the TFL, the side of the thigh. The external side of the left thigh, left hip down, right knee up, the foot to a 90 degree with the left leg.
Bring the left hand closer to your hips here, to your left hip, so you can press against the floor to extend the left rib cage up. Breathe in. Open your right arm to reach towards the left toes. Lift your heart, send it slightly forward, inhale. Lift the heart higher, lengthen left leg against the floor. And then now bring both sit bones down and bring the right ankle on the left side. Activate the right foot, both feet actually. Lift the heart forward, let the right knee come down, the right thigh. Right hand on the right thigh, you gently rotate the femur bone, the thigh bone out as you gently press down. Inhale softly through the nose. Exhale softly as you gently push down. Now keep the right ankle on the left thigh. Bring your blocks here in front. Hands on the blocks. You lengthen the torso forward a little. Keep the belly down and the chin up. Soften shoulders, face. Keep the toes active. Keep the right foot flexed. And slowly come out. Knees up. Grab the back of the knees, roll on your back a few times. Come forward. Cross the legs, high plank. Low plank, exhale, rotate arms out. Cobra inhale, or upward facing dog. Curl tailbone down, push the floor away, lift your heart. Shoulders rolling back and down, kneecaps off the mat. Downward facing dog, exhale. Left leg up. Bend and open. Rotate all three segments of your leg. The left leg, that is. Knee to chest, exhale. Inhale, lengthen up. Wild thing. Rise up through the chest, hips moving high above the floor, right leg straight. Three-legged dog, breathe in softly. And step forward. Lunge, interlace fingers behind the lower back. Lift the heart, inhale. Roll shoulders back, extend arms towards the back. Curl tailbone under. Press both feet down, lift your heart more, breathe in. Hands to your heart, right knee down. Come into your lunge twist. Bring the armpit as close to the thigh as you can. Bring the hand back to the center of the chest. Relax neck. Take the right kneecap off the mat. Roll the top shoulder back and away from the jaw. Breathe in and breathe out. Lower the right hand to a block or maybe fingertips down. Open the left arm up.
and come out. Runners lunge, hands on the blocks maybe. Right foot moving back, hips going low. Relaxing face. Move forward, rotate to bring the right hip down, the head of the thigh down, the left foot in front of you, perpendicular to the right leg, and you bring the right hand closer to the right hip to lift the right rib cage up. Inhale, extend the left arm towards the right toes. Press the right hand down to increase the space between the right hip and the lower rib here. Reach out towards the right toes. And come out slowly, lower the left knee down, left ankle on the right thigh. Move your heart forward and up. And as you exhale, slowly rotate the left thigh out. Use your Ujjayi breath. Listen to it. Make it longer, warmer. And as you exhale, gently press the left thigh down. Bring your hand close to the left hip. You don't want to press the knee down. You want to press here, close to the hip socket where we want to increase space. Then bring your hands forward, either side of the right leg, hands on the blocks, maybe your fingertips down. Keep the left foot flexed, active, and lengthen torso forward, inhale. Just a little, exhale to soften. Looking down, soften the gaze, breathe in, breathe out. And slowly come up. Bring the knees up. Roll on your back a few times. It's coming to an inversion. So you can do a restorative inversion, lifting the legs up, lower back on the block here, taking both legs up. Rest shoulders and the spine down. Bring the legs down slowly, flatten your back against the mat. Butterfly pose. Bring one hand on your belly, one hand on your heart. Close your eyes. Extend the left leg in front.
Bring the right knee close to the chest. Let's do a half happy baby pose. Drive the right arm inside of the right thigh. Catch the foot, flex the foot so the sole of the foot faces up, and gently lower the right knee towards the right shoulder. Make sure you don't bring your foot towards the ground here. Keep the lower leg vertical. Just feel the back of the thigh slowly opening. As the breath starts to relax and find more natural way of happening, the body will respond by softening. Most of the time, what comes in the way of a softening is the trying, the overdoing, the willpower. Now bring the knee to the opposite side, towards the floor, rotate the hips against the floor, and maybe you bring your knee to rest on a block, or two blocks, or a cushion. Rest the foot against the leg, rest both shoulder blades down on the floor. Left hand on the knee, maybe, and you open the right rib cage, and your arm above your head, but not in the air, against the floor. Just to open all the right side of the body and relax into lower back and lower abdomen. Keep the right knee high towards the chest. Close your eyes. Soften the breath. And come out. Bring the lower back flat. Switch legs. Place your blocks to the other side to receive the knee when you will twist or rotate. Lengthen the right leg and the left hamstring here. And then catch the outside of the foot. Flex the foot, lower the knee down. Relax face, neck, breath. Just stay here for a few breaths. Rotate the hips, bring the left knee outside or to the right side. Stay in your Ujjayi breath. Both shoulder blades flat, connected to the ground. You open the left arm up, left armpits, spread the left ribs, rib cage, left side. And let the knee rest in a way that the hip joints can relax. Relax the abdomen. The solar plexus. Relax your face. And come out. Grab both feet, happy baby pose. Keep the lower back, the sacrum, flat. on the floor. Catch the outside of both feet, or maybe the heels, and gently let the knees come closer to the armpits. No forcing. Maybe you grab the big toes. Just let it be for a moment. Notice how you feel in the hip joints. Notice if you tense, then don't. Find this place where you can accept what you feel with a soft breath and just stay there on the edge of your comfort zone. Just by virtue of accepting and be attentive, present, accepting, body will soften, and maybe you can gently bring the knees further down. Rock sideways, maybe. And then bring the feet down. Lift the tailbone up. Bring the spine down, each vertebra coming down, and then take both heels forward. As far forward as you can, then let the legs roll out freely and the feet. Lengthen both arms towards your feet. Spread the space between the shoulder blades. Then relax the weight of the whole body down. Let go of the ujjayi breath. Just stop, come to feel the ground beneath, the touch of the air in the nostrils, and feel your face softening from the eyebrow center down to your cheeks, nostrils, mouth, tongue, neck, through the shoulders. And let that sensation spread slowly throughout the whole body, all the way down to your wrist, palms of your hands, fingers, along the spine, through the hips, groin, thighs, the back of the knees, the calves, the Achilles, heels, sole of the feet, toes. Your belly moving up slowly. Ribcage spreading, expanding, collapsing slowly. Equalize your inhalation and exhalation in length and intensity. And let the body sink a little deeper. Notice the sounds all around you in the distance and close to you. The smell maybe around you, the temperature of the air on your skin. And then turn your senses inwardly, to notice the inner landscape, what it looks and feels like, physically, mentally, emotionally.
Notice if you can let go of the lower back a little more and the neck. You want to come out of Shavasana, start to lengthen your breath a little, bring some little movements in your extremities. Let your head roll from side to side. And slowly come up to sit tall and spacious, grounded through the sit bones, tall through the spine. Let's connect the hands together, taking a deep breath in. A full breath out. Thumb knuckles between the eyebrows. We bow forward to acknowledge ourselves and each and every one of us.